Yeah. broken door. The panic is cold outside, and I got nobody to love. They'll understand what I mean when I say there's no way we're gonna give up. And like an angel cries in the face of a monster that lives in a dream. It's unbearable now, babe, 'cause it's getting harder and harder to breathe. Is there anyone out there? 'Cause it's getting harder and harder.
Songbirds.
Secretary.
Mr. Bird.
Sir.
And did you hear the news about good old General Mercer?
No.
You know Claremont Street?
Yeah.
They renamed it after him. The Mercer legacy is secure.
Sure.
All he had to do was die.
Yeah, that's a lot less work.
We ought to give it a try.
Huh.
Now how you gonna get your debt plan through?
I guess I'm gonna finally have to listen to you. Sorry, Burr, I gotta go.
But
decisions are happening over there.
Two Virginians and an immigrant walk into a room
diametrically opposed foes.
They emerge with a compromise, having opened doors that were previously closed. The immigrant emerges with unprecedented financial power, a system can shape however he wants. The Virginians emerge with the nation's capital. It's the pièce de résistance. No one else was in the room where it happened. The room where it happened. The room where it happened. No one else was in the room where it happened. The room where it happened. The room where it happened. No one really knows how the game is played. The art of the trade, how the sausage gets made. We just assume that it happens. No one else is in the room where it happens.
Thomas claims
Alexander was on Washington's doorstep one day in distress and disarray.
Thomas claims
Alexander said,
I've nowhere else to turn,
and basically begged me to join the fray.
Thomas claims
I approached Madison and said, I know you hate him, but let's hear what he has to say.
Thomas claims
well, I arranged the meeting. I arranged the menu, the seating.
But no one else was in the room where it happened. The room where it happened. The room where it happened. No one else was in the room where it happened. The room where it happened. The room where it happened. No one really knows how the party gets yes. The pieces that are sacrificed in every game of chess. We just assume that it happens. But no one else is in the room where it happened.
Meanwhile, Madison is grappling with the fact that not every issue can be settled by committee.
Meanwhile,
Congress is fighting over where to put the capital. It isn't pretty. Jefferson approaches with the dinner and invite. Madison responds with Virginia insight.
Maybe we can solve one problem with the government and bring a victory for the Southerners. In other words, a quid pro quo.
I suppose.
Wouldn't you like to work a little closer to home?
Actually, I would.
Well, I propose the tone.
And you'll provide him his vote.
Well, we'll see how it goes.
Let's go.
No.
What else was in the room?
Yeah.
what they say, all toasters toast toast. Thank you.